Well, hello, Crisp Academy. You caught me enjoying a cup of coffee. You know, I love coffee. You already know that I'm obsessed with Legos, but I have a couple of other favorite things. One of them is coffee. I love really good coffee, and I try it everywhere I go, and I have certain coffee shops and people that I just think do a great job. I even roast my own sometimes. I order the beans from South America and Africa and Indonesia, and then I roast them up myself in a popcorn maker and try to roast it just the way I like it. So I really enjoy a good cup of coffee. And because I like coffee so much, I also started a collection of coffee mugs. So I'm going to show you a few of the coffee mugs that I have collected.
Way down among Brazilians, coffee beans grow by the billions. So they've got to find those extra cups to fill. They've got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. You can't get cherry soda, 'cause they've got to fill that quota. And the way things are, I'll bet they never will. They've got a zillion tons of coffee in Brazil. No tea or tomato juice, you'll see. No potato juice, 'cause the planners down in Santa's all say no, no, no. The politician's daughter was accused of drinking water and was fined a great big $50 bill. They've got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil.
And so this one here is very special to me too. Some years ago, some folks at my church volunteered, and we did a lot of work reaching out to folks in our neighborhood to try to share the gospel. And to tell them thank you, I bought everybody one of these mugs. And so every time I use this mug, I think about the people in my church and how much they love Christ and how much they want to share the gospel, and I pray for them. I actually use these coffee mugs as a way to, little prayer reminders. And so I have a selection of them, and each day when I pull one out, some remind me of my children, some remind me of my church, some remind me of Christian Academy. And so when I pull out that coffee mug, then I pray for the folks that those mugs remind me of. For example, maybe my kids go to Crossing camp for my church and my own children. And so I keep this out in the summertime, and I pray for the people that are working in the Crossing summer camp. Some of them are just weird. I don't know why. I found this one at a yard sale. It looks like a vertebrae. And so who knows? Sometimes I just get weird ones. Sometimes I have ones that remind me of places we went on vacation. Every time we go on vacation, all over the world or anywhere we go, I look for a coffee mug. And when I use that coffee mug, it reminds me of the good times that we had and how God just blessed our family to be able to go on trips and vacation. I have ones from St. Louis because that's where my wife's family is from, and from all over. Wherever I go, I collect coffee mugs to remind me of awesome places that I've been able to go. And I have two coffee mugs that are really special to me. I wouldn't trade them for any amount of money in the whole world. And I'm going to show them to you. One is this one. And another one is this one here. Now, I wonder if you could guess why those two are so special. I mean, I like all of them, and I have coffee mugs from all the different colleges that I have attended, different places that I've taught, places that I've been. Those are all really neat to me and special. But these two in particular are really, really special. And I think this month of March, as we are starting out our missions month to collect items for the families at the Loving Choice Resource Center, and as we're also preparing for World Down Syndrome Day later in the month, and we've been watching some of those videos, I think it would be a good chance to stop and talk about these two really special mugs. And so let's start with this one. So this one, you'd say, well, it's not really terribly fancy. I keep finding, where's the camera? It's not terribly fancy. You think, well, I could buy one nicer than that. What makes this one really special is it was made by my brother. My brother is a little younger than me, and we are really close. We've always been really good friends, and he went to the same college that I went to. And when he was in college, he took a pottery class. And so he made lots of things in pottery class, and this is one of the things that he made in his college pottery class, and he gave it to me, and I've kept it all these years since college, and whenever I use it, I think about my brother, how much he means to me, and how glad I am that we were able to go to college together, and then now he also moved to Kentucky, so we just live a couple miles from each other, and we get to see each other as often as we want to. And so that's a real blessing to me. But what makes this mug special is who made it. Because my brother made it. And that makes it special. And it's not like any other one. And that reminds me of Psalms 139, verse 14. Psalms 139, 14. I will give you thanks, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, and my soul knows this very well. You know, boys and girls, when we think about all the different variety of people and the different colors and hairstyles and the way in which God has made each and every one of us special. Again, I have hundreds of mugs. This one is really, really special to me. Because of who made it. And so I want us to remember this month, as we're thinking about helping out these families at the Loving Care Resource Center, these children are just like you. They're special in God's sight. They're made by Him. And their families are just struggling. These children will not have a mom and dad who are blessed financially like you are, and your parents can send you to a Christian school. And most of us have plenty of food. We have plenty of clothes. We have more than we need of toys. We have plenty. And so, but just because some children don't have very much doesn't mean they're not worth as much. They're very, very special because of who made them. They were made by God. And whether they have Down syndrome or whether they have weird hair, or whether they need to wear glasses, or I had a friend in school that didn't have one arm. And God made each and every one of us, and we are all precious and special in His sight because of who made us. So we need to make sure that we realize that every single person we ever see is handmade by God, and He loves them, and they are special because of who made them. Now, the other mug. Aha. Now this one, I don't know who made it. Actually, it doesn't say on the bottom. This was made by a company, a factory. They made this. So it's not really special because of who made it. Ah, what's special on this one is the image that's on it. So I'm going to see if I can move this up here for you. That is my oldest daughter, Trinity. That's my middle daughter, Autumn. They're now in their 20s and they're teachers. This is my son, Justice. This is hilarious. He is a junior at Christian Academy. If you saw him now, he doesn't look anything like that. But if you do see him, if you know Justice and you see him, you tell him, you say, I saw your little baby face on that your dad's mug. So if you know Justice at all, we find him. He's a tall kid. He's a kid with a junior with wild red hair. And so you'll recognize him. He looks just like this. But what makes this mug special and priceless to me is whose image is on it. Those images of my children are priceless. And if you were to look at them and look at pictures of me, you would see that in some way or another, each of my children has some way in which they kind of look like me, because that's sort of the way God made us. And so each one of these children is so precious to me because, and on this mug, their image is what makes it priceless. And we have another verse in our Bible. It's actually all the way back in Genesis, where God is making the world. And He makes animals and plants, and He makes the sun and the moon, and He makes everything you can think of. And then God says, And God said, let us make humans in our image according to our likeness. Let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and over the cattle of all the earth and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humans in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them, and God blessed them. So you know what? Every single person you meet are special because God made them. Like this mug that I told you about, what makes it special is who made it. Every single person you ever see is made by God. But what also makes them special, the Bible tells us that each person has been made in the image of God. So the fact that they have the image of God in them, and whether they look like you or not, whether their skin is darker than yours or lighter than yours, maybe their eyes are a different color, maybe their ears are different than yours. Each and every one of us is different and special and unique, but all of us are made in the image of God. And what makes us special, priceless, is that we carry in us, every single one of us, you do too, that you are made in the image of God. And so this mug is so special to me because of the image that's on it. And you are special to God because when he looks at you, he sees his image. He sees how much he loves you because you are his child and you bear his image. I want us this week to be especially careful and mindful that every person we speak to was made by God and made in the image of God. And I want us to treat them that way. You know, it'd be easier for us to put up with people if we think, wow, they're made by God. They're made in the image of God. You might get a little frustrated. You might be impatient. But you know what? They're made in the image of God, and God loves them, and they bear his image. And so I want you to be aware that you are made by God, and you bear the image of God. And every single person you are around today, the person in your classroom, the person to your right and your left, the person behind you, the teacher in your room, everybody in carpool, everybody on your sports team, everybody that you see, every single person made by God and bears the image of God. And so we should be able to show love and respect to them because of who they are and who made them. So I hope that was interesting to you, and I believe that we can, each of us, come away and pull our head up a little taller, knowing that we have been made by God and made in the image of God. Oh, I have one last mug to see you out with. Life is good. All right. God bless you. I'll be praying for you. You pray for me, and I will see you next week.